فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, we have just completed the 15th Taraweeh here in Harare, Zimbabwe, and that depicts almost the middle of Ramadan. If we were to have 29 nights of Ramadan, then we have got almost to the center. And if we have 30, then subhanallah, we would still have an extra day. But this goes to show that Ramadan is actually moving so quick, we'd better make the best use of this beautiful month of Ramadan. My brothers and sisters, this evening I heard the recitation and I participated also in Salat al-Taraweeh of Surah Al-Kahf, Surah Maryam, as well as Surah Taha. And I promise you, something that really stands out for me from Surah Al-Kahf is a very, very powerful point. And we always read Surah Al-Kahf, but sometimes we don't realize that, you know, this surah, the calmness that it is supposed to be giving us, it's the word of Allah. The word of Allah is supposed to calm us. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Those who believe are definitely, they achieve the contentment and calmness of the hearts through the remembrance of Allah. For indeed, it is only through the remembrance of Allah that the calmness of the heart is actually achieved. So if you were to look at the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you were to look at the Quran and its meaning, and you were to think about it and ponder over it, it has in it great lessons for every one of us. Let's take a look at this surah, Surah Al-Kahf, the one story of Al-Khidr with Musa alayhi salam. So Al-Khidr happened to do three things, and those three things seemed to be negative, but in actual fact, they were very, very positive in the long run. And this goes to show that if we believe and we do good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ever let us down. Al-Khidr, the first thing he did, well, there were three things. One of the things he did was he made a hole in a boat that was going downstream that they were actually getting a lift with. And it looks like it was very negative, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they were honest people, youngsters, very honest, really good young people who were doing business by carrying, ferrying people across and goods across. And downstream there was a tyrant who was taking away all the good boats. So Allah says, we inspired Al-Khidr to make a hole in the boat so that it would not be taken away. And even though a hole in the boat seems very negative, it was actually the best thing that could have happened to them. They did not lose the entire boat. The same applies if we were to look at the next thing that happened, where a young boy was eradicated because Allah knew that's the time of the death of the youngster. And Allah knew that if that youngster was given life, he would be a means or a source of distress and difficulty, hardship, perhaps, of the parents. So Allah says, we will take the child away at an age where we know the child will go to Jannah, and we will give the parents another child who will be better than that child, and they will not be suffering as a result of what that child would have done because the child was taken away by Allah. So if you lose a loved one, all you and I need to know is that Allah knows what He has done. The timing of Allah is absolutely perfect. We don't know the future, Allah knows the future. For as long as you believe and you do good deeds, Allah will not let you down. Whatever's happened in your life, if you have a hole in your boat, for example, you've lost a job, you have made a loss in your business. For example, you may have suffered a robbery. You may have, a business burnt down. You may have gone through divorce. You may have sickness. No matter what type of a hole is in your ship, you need to know upstream, Allah wants to protect you because there is a tyrant either upstream or downstream, but further up, there is a tyrant who perhaps would be usurping all the goodness. So Allah says, we took away some because we want to give you back so much more in return. That's a very, very powerful, interesting point. Similar with the youngster. When Allah's taken away someone, you need to know that was the best timing. Yes, we will be sad. Yes, we will miss them. Yes, we must make dua for them. Yes, we will do whatever we can, you know, and we have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But my brothers and sisters, Allah knows that was the best thing for you. That timing was superb. Had it been delayed by a moment or taken earlier, by a moment, perhaps it would have been very, very dangerous for us and our well-being. And the third thing regarding Al-Khidr was he straightened a wall, and the people of that particular town refused to be hospitable and to even give the guests a little bit of that hospitality that was supposed to be. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, that particular wall, beneath it there was a treasure for two orphans. These orphans, their parents were salih. Salih meaning they were pious, they were good, they were our friends, they believed and did good deeds. Because of their belief and good deeds, we took care of their children as well. We took care of the sustenance of their children as well. So Allah says that the parents had gone away. They had left behind a treasure under a wall. The wall was about to collapse. Had it collapsed, perhaps people may have usurped that wealth. So Allah says, we inspired Al-Khidr to straighten the wall as a gift for the parents and the children. Now, the moral of all these three, for me, is that if you believe and do good deeds, Allah will take care of you and your offspring. Subhanallah. So amazing, amazing. Look at Surah Al-Kahf. No matter what you have a sickness and illness, whatever it is, Allah does not do bad things to you. You believe and you do good deeds, whatever has happened, it's just a hole in your boat, like I would say, taken from Surah Al-Kahf. And inshallah, you will realize as time passes why that was a gift of Allah upon you. So don't become evil, don't be harsh, don't be hard. Learn to appreciate the gifts of Allah upon you. And I promise you, a day will come when you will be smiling all the way and you're going to say, oh Allah, indeed, when you took that thing away from me, or when I suffered a loss back in the days, it was the best thing that could have happened. So my brothers and sisters, here we are in the month of Ramadan, almost over. We ask Allah to bless you all and every one of us. أقول قولي هذا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.